Okay, now finally, we are going to talk about the main theme of this lecture series, the ergodicity. First, what is ergodicity? The English word ergodic itself means ubiquitous or everywhere. But this is not something you can see immediately from the definition of the ergodicity. In mathematics, this corresponds to the fact that almost all orbits under ergodic action is dense. I have a video talking about this fact, but this is not something that we want to worry about today. Today we are going to introduce just the definition of ergodicity and some examples. So, in the today's setting, the word ergodicity means the indecomposability of a measure space. And specifically, it means that it is impossible to split a measure space into two subsets of positive measure. And at the same time, each of them is invariant under an ergodic transformation. And now let me write down the definition. So this is definition 2.13 in the book. A measure preserving transformation T from X to itself of a probability space X B mu is called ergodic if for any measurable subset B that is strictly invariant under T, we have this subset as it has zero measure or full measure. This is equation 2.2 in the book. And this is what I mean by the indecomposability. And there are some other ways to say this. For example, when the emphasis is on the map, T from X to X, and we are studying different T invariant measures. We will also say the mu is an ergodic measure for T. The definition of ergodicity is interesting because we can have several characterizations of the ergodicity other than this one. And those are provided by the following proposition. The following are equivalent properties for a measure preserving transformation T of the measure space X, B, mu. First, T is ergodic. And second, we're going to replace this condition with the measure theoretic one. For any B measurable with the measure of T inverse B and B, the symmetric difference equal to zero implies that the measure of B is zero or one. And thirdly, For any variable subset A that is of positive measure, we have the measure of the union of all pullbacks of A under this ergodic transformation. This has measure 1. This means if you consider all the backward orbits of the points in A, and you take the union of all of them, this gives you the full measure. And this also justifies the name of ergodic in some sense, which means the orbits can be everywhere on the space. Fourthly, for any two measurable subsets, such that both of them have positive measure, we have that there exists a positive integer with the measure of T inverse of A in the section B is positive. Now all those four properties are about sets. The last one is about functions. Now 5. For f from x to c, a measurable function. So if we have f composed with t is equal to f almost everywhere, then we'll have f is equal to a constant almost everywhere. And this says under the ergodic condition, there will be impossible to have a non-constant t-invariant function, which should be natural to you.